My grandma, Cecile, or Cilla, should have turned 106 today. But earlier this year, she said, "Darlings, I have 13 days left and then the party is over." But in this goodie bag, we have a present from her. Couple secrets, how to live to reach 100 years old mark and in good health. By the way, that's her celebrating one century on this planet and totally kicking ass. So I'm going to deliver this present to you today, now, because as I said, it's a birthday, and what would be a better way to celebrate such a long and amazing life? Because just imagine, getting born during the Great War, before the Soviet Union, in a place without electricity or antibiotics, and living through all that, and cars, nuclear power, television, rockets, computers, internet. Given she wasn't that much impressed with the last 20 years, but what can you do? You and I, we can only hope to live long enough to see as many changes as she did. So that's why you should know about what she did right. There are a couple tips here. One extreme superpower to unlock, and one, well, you'll see. Number one, not living alone. My grandma has always lived together with kids and grandkids in the same house. It's almost a superpower in itself, just not as mighty as what's coming next. But let's unpack not living alone first. You know how certain longevity enthusiasts are hoping to live longer by infusing themselves with younger blood? Well, there is another way to achieve something similar, and that's to be a part of the household where all the generations are mixed up. When you get involved with the young, you get some of that energy, and your body senses that you are useful, something is going on, and you get a lot of health benefits. So what can you do now? Nurture a community around you where you have friends of all ages, so it becomes a norm in your circle. That's a win-win for everyone right now and unlocks a better future for you. Number two, always engaged. Staying engaged with the news and the world. Solving Sudokus was never enough for my grandma. She was always engaged with the local news, with what's going on in the world, with the technology. We got the news from her. That's how you keep your mind sharp. How often do you see your parents or grandparents not using new technology just because they're afraid to look stupid or lose their authority? Well, your action item is not to be like that. Be okay with looking stupid sometimes and keep educating yourself. Good news, that's what you do right now, that's what we do on this channel. And if you like the idea, I'd appreciate you hitting some of the buttons below. And number three, cooking at home, eating fresh. It was either cooked fresh with my grandma or cooked fresh. There was no second option. We are what we eat, it's that simple. I'm usually not the one to scare people with food, any food. Those make the poison, not what you eat. But when you cook at home from the natural ingredients, it's triple whammy. You get more beneficial micronutrients, you get less calories, and you avoid all the 10,000 food additives, which are supposed to be safe in isolation, but together, who knows. So it's not actually as much as what to avoid, but what to add. When you cook, it naturally replaces the processed and preserved stuff. So your action, allocate more time to cooking. I'll leave my favorite longevity meal recipe down below, and your task is to check it out and try at least once to see how easy it is to cook and how amazing it tastes. Number four, walking daily. Yeah, simple. My grandma lived on the third floor, no elevator, and went up and down daily and walked. Was she able to manage stairs because she did them daily, or she did them daily because she could? Quite often we stop doing things because we think that we are too old. But it's actually when we stop, we do become old. So it can be a negative feedback loop or positive feedback loop. Scientifically, all the above, all this, falls under active grandparent hypothesis. But bottom line, life is movement. Movement is life. So your task, get a pair of headphones, go for a walk and listen to a podcast, or watch a few YouTube videos, or even easier, as the family history goes, I got these breathing exercises from my dad, but he got it, you guess it, from my grandma. It's not hard, not physically hard, it's only hard to find 2 minutes to do them. So if living to 100 is a priority for you, which it should be, right? Then start small, but put it on your schedule. And getting close. Sleep on the schedule. Because speaking about schedules, what my grandma did like a clockwork. She went to sleep every day at the same time. And sleep is amazing for health and longevity for multiple reasons. And I think the only thing better than sleep is regular sleep and consistent sleep. That actually leads us to first superpower. Having a solid and consistent schedule for everything. When you do things consistently, even small positive changes, they start to accumulate. Here, just for this video. The power of compound interest, eighth wonder of the world, if you believe this dude. But it wasn't just going to a bed at the same time as her. It was also waking up at the same time. Going for a walk on a schedule, not missing a single appointment, taking every single pill. Precise and organized to the T. So when one day, this spring, she said that she has 13 days left to live, we all knew what to expect. And, you know, maybe it was a coincidence, but as I said, she never missed an appointment. Or maybe it was fate, because there is no doubt that her second superpower was luck. And you see, we can reproduce all the tips she left us, but we cannot do the same with luck. However, we can do the second best thing. Think carefully about every single aspect of what it takes to live to be 100 years old by design, not by luck. And I already did that for you in this video. What other people call luck, biology calls the law of minimum. And the sooner you start applying it to your life, the luckier you're gonna be. So, happy birthday, as the luck has it, it's my birthday today too. Welcome to the family, and I'll see you in the next video.